on this holiday of Shmini Atzeret and into tonight and tomorrow with Simchat Torah, we are reminded that this two-day period on the Jewish calendar is a time for beginnings and endings. Of course, yesterday with Hoshana Rabbah, we really drew to an end the holiday season. The season of repentance really came to a close with Hoshana Rabbah yesterday. And today we began a new season. In Israel, it would begin the winter season. We pray for rain. A little strange for us in Michigan, but pray for rain in the land of Israel and hope that they have a successful and prosperous rainy season in order for their crops to grow. And of course, that's a sign of God accepting our prayers. That's a sign of God granting us the forgiveness for which we've asked over these last many weeks. So Shmini Atzeret in and of itself is a time for endings and beginnings. And of course, tonight into tomorrow, as we celebrate Simchat Torah, we'll conclude reading from the Torah with the book of Deuteronomy, and right away we'll start again tomorrow morning with the book of Genesis. Simchat Torah, too, is a time of endings and beginnings, beginnings and endings. Now, you can tell a lot about a story by how it begins and by how it ends. So if we look at the Torah itself as we celebrate Simchat Torah, we see that the Torah begins and ends with death. In the beginning, Adam and Eve eat from the tree of knowledge of good and evil, and among their punishments for this is death. God brings death into the world. Fast forward to Deuteronomy. How does the book of Deuteronomy end? How does the Torah end? Moses dies by a kiss from God and ascends to heaven. Death is in the beginning. Death is at the end. And so what we come to see with the Torah is that the entire Torah is a commentary on life in proximity to death. That we can't understand life, we can't appreciate life, that life is lived with the awareness of death. That's, of course, somewhat of a depressed read of the Torah. Other rabbis come to teach in the Midrash that no, the Torah shouldn't be read as if it begins and ends with death, but rather the Torah begins and ends with kindness. Because as soon as Adam and Eve eat from the tree of knowledge of good and evil, they're aware of their nakedness, and God clothes them. The very first act that God does after their sin is God gives clothing to Adam and Eve. It's a profound act of kindness in the midst of their nakedness. And how does the Torah end? The Torah ends not with Moses dying, but with God making sure that Moses receives a proper burial. This is, of course, the act that we call in our own times Chesed Shel Emet, the great kindness of truth. The Torah begins with God granting kindness to Adam and Eve. The Torah ends with God showing profound kindness to Moshe Rabbeinu, to Moses, our rabbi. So the Torah should really be read in its beginning and its end about kindness. The Torah is a commentary on kindness. Still other rabbis chime in and say, no, if we look at the beginning and the end of the Torah, it's all about justice. Because the Torah really begins when Cain kills Abel. And God asks the question, what's going on here? And Cain responds with the rhetorical question, am I my brother's keeper? The next five books of Moses, perhaps the entire Hebrew Bible after that, is the answer to Cain's question, am I my brother's keeper? The answer being a profound, yes, we are our brother's keeper. The Torah begins with that moment of injustice and a reminder of our obligation to perform justice, because of course, the Torah comes to an end in Deuteronomy with the words, tzedek, tzedek, tirdof. As our ancestors are preparing to enter the promised land, God tells them, justice, justice shall you pursue. Perhaps the Torah then is a profound commentary from beginning to end on justice. But as we transition today and tomorrow into this new season, what we come to see is the Torah and this time of year is not just about beginnings and endings or endings and beginnings. It's about the infinite loop that is the experience of humanity. It's about eternality. It's about the infinite. It's about the never ending. Because when we say these prayers for Geshem, for rain, we link ourselves with our brothers and sisters across the world, but we also link ourselves through time with the prayers of our people. Back into the past, forward into the future. As we bring the Torah scroll into ourselves tonight and tomorrow, and we continue over and over again to read the story of our people, we wrap ourselves in the text, and thus we become part of the eternal story that is the Jewish people. We also, at this hour of Yisker, we affirm that there is no end, there is no beginning, that the soul always was, that the soul is, and that the soul always will be. And so as we look at this profound moment of now, with beginnings and endings, we're reminded that when we perform kindness as the Torah commands us, when we perform justice as the Torah commands us, we actually link ourselves into that infinite. We bind ourselves to the eternal. We live that commentary on death by giving meaning to life. When we wrap ourselves in the story of the Jewish people, we actually bring heaven and earth closer together. We blur the lines between beginnings and endings because all is eternal. What we do here on earth impacts the souls of our loved ones. When we perform acts of kindness and justice in this world in memory of those who've gone before, we bring them a little closer to us. And we pray at this hour, too, that we should feel their nearness. We should feel the presence of those who've gone before. Because Jewish tradition teaches that what happens in the heavenly realms impacts the earthly realms as well. So as we transition now to our Yisker service, I'll invite you to take out your Yisker booklets. They're in the back of the room if you didn't pick one up on the way in. And as we begin on this holiday of Shmini Atzeret and into Simchat Torah to contemplate the meaning of beginnings and endings, of endings and beginnings, I'll invite you to remember that what we do now is also a profound act of the infinite. It's celebrating the eternality of the Jewish people, the eternality of God. And it affirms and it honors that our souls live forever as well, and that we can connect to those who've entered the heavenly realm. We turn now to the Yisker service. We begin with the 23rd Psalm. We're on page, I believe, 2 in our Yisker booklets.
Mizmor LeDavid, Adonai Roi Lorsad, Binot Deshe Yarbitzeini, Armei Menuchot, Yenaleini. Nafshi Yishovev, Yishovev, Yanchaini v'maglei tzedek, Yanchaini v'maglei tzedek, Leman Shemo. Gam ki eilech begeis el mavet, lo ira ra ki ata imadi, shivtecha umi shantecha, Amuni Taruch lefanai, lefanai Shulchan neged tzorerai Dishanta v'ashemen roshi Kosi revaya Yerdefuni kol yemei chayai, kol yemei chayai, v'shavti Beweit Adonai Leyarech Yamim Adonai Rohi Lochsan Adonai Rohi
Please join me as we read together responsively on page 86. The words of Rabbi Morris Adler, a blessed memory. The earth has covered only that which was mortal, of those to whom we have said our farewell.
We shall not see again the familiar glowing face, the warm illuminated eye, nor hear the beloved voice.
We shall not sit face to face across the family table or side by side in the home of a friend or in worship.
We shall not feel the kiss that once evoked our deepest response.
Yet death has failed and must surrender.
For the beloved who is gone lives and will always live through the years.
Not in some distant corner of our being to be uncovered only in a rare moment or by a sudden surge of recall.
The beloved has become a presence indwelling and inseparable.
Rooted so deep that life cannot carry us far from the cherished, now hallowed center of memory and love.
Your hand, O death, has been stayed. You can no longer inflict oblivion.
Or doom to full disappearance those who are life of our life.
They live and move within us in spheres beyond your dominion.
We thank thee, O God of life and love, for the resurrecting gift of memory,
which endows thy children, fashioned in thy image, with the godlike sovereign power to give immortality through love.
Blessed be thou, O God, who enablest thy children to remember. We continue on page 4 with Shiviti.
Shiviti Adonai L'negni tami Kimimini valemot Lachein somach li Ve'yagel kevodi af besari nishkon lavetach. Amen.
I invite you to once again turn to the back of your Yisker booklets. We turn to page 87. Page 87, we will offer the words of our beloved Rabbi Erwin Groner, a blessed memory. Dear God, we come before you as individuals created in your image and as a congregation in Israel to thank you for your blessings. We're grateful for inspiring moments. We ask not to be relieved of our burdens, but to be fortified to bear them. We ask not for a spontaneous solution to our problems, but rather for the guidance to meet them with firmness and understanding. We ask not for an escape from the difficult choices we make, but rather for insight and courage to choose wisely and bravely. It seems to some of us that we've lost you. Dare we commend ourselves to you, we who've been given so much? We can lay no compelling claim to added blessings, yet we must. You know how frail we are, how uncertain is our life. Our very existence is in your hands. Another year and we grow older along with. Life becomes more precious as we sense time's rapid passing. If only we could grow in wisdom as we grow in years. Your prophet declared, "Seek the Lord where he can be found." Where shall we find you? And where shall we not find you? Some of us have known gladness and fulfillment. Others have known sorrow and disappointment. Some of our lives have been touched by moments of high ecstasy, and some have been seared by unspeakable tragedy. You were ever with us. You sustained us. You uplifted us. If only we could have opened our eyes. Link our names with prophets and sages and saints who labored to preserve your teaching. Enable us to continue their sacred work. Unroll our days as a scroll, and use our lives as holy parchment in which to inscribe eternal truths. Help us to make our page meaningful and our script sincere, an acceptable offering to you. Enable us to encounter you in the sacred legacy of our tradition. Enable us to love you with all our heart, with all our soul, and with all our might. Come closer to us and remain in our midst. We do not want to fail you. But God, do not fail us. You are our loving Father. We are humbly and devoutly your children. And let us say together, Amen. I'll invite the congregation to please rise as Yirona Kodesh is opened. We turn in our Yisker booklets to pages 6 through 10. Pages 6 through 10 as we offer the individual Yisker meditations. Yizkor Elohim, Nishmot Krovai Verei. Yizkor Elohim, Nishmot Kol Achenu Shemasru Et Nafsham Al Kiddush Hashem. Yizkor Elohim, Nishmot Kol Achenu Bnei Yisrael, Shenitbachu B'Shoah. Yizkor Elohim, Nishmot Chayalei Tzva Hagana L'Yisrael, Shemasru Et Nafsham Al Kiddushat Hashem Ha'am Va'aretz. May God remember the souls of all of our brothers and sisters, friends and family, relatives and friends who've gone to their eternal home. May God remember the souls of the martyrs of our people, including the men and women, the children, who perished in the Shoah, the Holocaust of World War II. May God remember the souls of our brothers and sisters in the State of Israel, who gave their lives for the sanctification of the name of God, the Jewish people, and the land of Israel. In memory of all of them, may we endeavor to perpetuate ideals important to them. Through such deeds and through prayer and memory, are the souls bound up in the bond of life. May these moments of meditation strengthen the ties that link us to their memories. May they rest forever in dignity and peace, with fullness of joy in the comfort of the Eternal One. And let us say together, Amen. We turn now to the memorial prayer. We're on page 14.
El Malei Rachamim Shochein B'Maromim Hamtzei Menucha Nechona Tachat Kanfei HaShechina B'Malot Kedoshim Kedoshim Otehorim Kezor HaRakia Mazehirim Et Nishmot Kol Eileh Shizkanu Hayom Livracha She'alechu Leolamam Began Eden Began Eden Tehi Menuchatam Ana Bala Rachamim Hasirehen Deseter Krofecha Leolamim Utzeror bitzeror achayim Utzeror bitzeror achayim Et nishmotehem Adonai hu nachalatam V'yanuchu b'shalom V'yanuchu b'shalom Al mishkevoteihem b'shalom V'nomar Amen.
Exalted, compassionate God, grant infinite rest in your sheltering presence among the holy and the pure, to the souls of our loved ones who've gone to their eternal home. Merciful One, we ask that they find perfect peace in your tender embrace. May their memories endure, inspiring truth and loyalty in our lives. May their souls be bound up in the bond of life. May they forever rest in peace. And let us say together, Amen. Amen. We'll join now in the words of the Mourner's Kaddish on page 15. Yid Gadal, Yid Kadash, Shemei Rabbah, Mialma divra kirute viamlich malchute b'chayechon uviyomechon b'chaye dechol beit Yisrael magala uvizman kari vimru amen yehesh me rabba mevorach leolam ulmei olmaya yitbarach vishtabach vitpa'ar vitromam vitnasei vithador vitale vithalal shmei dekudesha barichu La'ela min kol birchata v'shirata Tushbechata v'nechamata Damiran mi'alma v'imru amen Yehesh lama rabba min shemaya V'chayim aleinu v'al kol Yisrael v'imru amen Oseh shalom b'imromav Hu ya'aseh shalom Aleinu v'al kol Yisrael v'imru amen May God comfort the bereaved among us and grant peace to each and everyone who are in need. We say together, Amen.